Hi everyone, welcome to JustFeg Network TV, a place where you can get the latest information on things happening around the world, and you are in the right place. Please click the red subscribe button and also press the bell icon next to it so you can be notified for an update on any published news. Human rights lawyer Femi Falana and former governor of Kaduna State Balarabe Musa have warned against ethnic profiling of criminals, saying it may lead to a complete state of anarchy in the country. In a statement entitled Time to Save Nigeria, jointly issued yesterday, the two eminent Nigerians stated that it was high time all stakeholders put hands together to save the country from disintegration. They also urged elder statesmen in the country to desist from issuing hate speech and irresponsible ultimatum that could heighten the current state of insecurity. The statement read, amid the cacophony of ethnic and regional voices, it is imperative that pan-Nigerian voices should be heard louder than ever before to save Nigeria from disintegration. The symbol of the brewing socio-political crisis are manifest. The Nigerian state has failed to tackle the worsening insecurity plaguing every part of the country. Nigeria is increasingly being defined by insecurity. Killings have become almost a daily affair in Nigeria. Terror attacks, banditry, kidnapping and armed robbery are perpetrated by criminals with reckless abandon. In practical terms, no part of Nigeria is immune to violent crimes, although the incidents might be relatively higher in one part than the other at this time. Tragic news of life wasted issued from the north and south, east and west, in response to the flourishing crimes in the face of the worrisome incompetency of the state. Ethnics and regional champions have resorted into the dangerous ethnic profiling and demonization of others. It is the reign of hate speech and marketing of prejudice. Claiming to speak for our people, they issue irresponsible ultimatum and orders for which they lack constitutional authority to enforce. Some of those who are supposed to act as statesmen at these critical hours have instead joined the rank of issues of prejudicial statements. Nigeria must not be turned into killing field. The draw asked President Muhammadu Buhari to look into suggestions from conferences and panels set up by the federal government in the past in order to find solutions to the challenges affecting the country. The appropriate response to this sectional voice is not to glibly question the patriotism of any person or group. The effective response is to compel the Nigerian state under the watch of President Muhammadu Buhari to perform the constitutional duty of keeping Nigeria secure. Nigeria must not be turned into a killing field. The way to take the wings out of the sails of mansions of it is for the government to confront the worsening insecurity in Nigeria squarely and honestly. Law enforcement and other security agencies should fight crimes competently and strictly according to the law. In doing so, the ethnic and religion identity of the criminals is not of any importance. Rather, ethnic and religion profiling could distract from the urgent task of stamping out crime. The truth is that every ethnic and religious group has its own share of criminals. We must separate crimes from prejudice so that criminals could be fought with a unity of purpose as a nation. It is also an indisputable fact that the victim of criminal activities belongs to the various ethnic group and religion. We are convinced that the urgency of the situation should compel the Buhari administration to rethink its internal security strategy by considering some of the patriotic suggestions from conferences and panels set up by government in the last few years. They also demanded that the police and other security agencies be well equipped to tackle the current dimension of insecurity in the country. The justice system, especially in the state, should be alert to the responsibility of diligence and swift prosecution of arrest suspected criminals. It is the duty of the respective attorney general in the affected state to prosecute suspected killers, kidnappers, and armed robbers. All these triads of governments have responsibility for security, working in unison. If the degeneration in the Nigerian condition is not halted, the nations may descend into anarchy. Doubtless, the poor people will bear the brunt of such an avoidable disaster. We therefore call on the president to rally the country round a national purpose for security everywhere in Nigeria, as the constitution demands. The leadership dispute should be in words and action. And also the leadership duty should be in word and action. The president should address the nation specifically for the purpose of giving assurance of his commitment to the unity of Nigeria. He might adequate security. It is also the duty of genuine lovers of peace, freedom, and development of Nigeria to speak up in order to save the nation from descent of anarchy. So what do you think about this particular news? Your comment is highly appreciated below. Please kindly put your comment at the comment section. And thank you all for listening once again. Don't forget to press the right eye icon and subscribe to my channel. Bye.